sub psi star curly psi over curly x minus psi curly psi star over curly x. And I will put the integration limit from minus infinity to plus infinity. Now what about, I know about the wave function. Psi x of t goes to 0 is x goes to plus minus infinity. I know this. Why? Because my wave function is a distribution. And this distribution or this wave function goes to 0 is x goes to infinity. Such a wave function I call a normalized wave function. So if this wave function is normalized wave function, I put the value of this means x at infinity, plus infinity and minus infinity, my wave function should go to 0. And this means that d over dt of sine mod square dx will be equal to 0. Because my wave function is not defined at those points. Otherwise, if this is not true, if this is not true, then my wave function is not normalized. I assumed earlier that my wave function is normalized and it will stay normalized for infinite time. So with time it will not change. And now I prove that yes, if this is a normalized wave function, then this thing will be equal to 0. So there is no time evolution of the wave function. Clear? So this result we will need, and further we can do more calculations. Okay, so wave function will stay normalized. Now the another question is that is the expectation value of x is equal to this? Include one momentum operator as well. And what was momentum operator? Momentum operator, in the previous lecture, we proved that the momentum operator P is minus I h bar curly over curly x. Or you can write h bar over I curly by curly x. Now I know one thing, that momentum generally is equal to mv, and I can write this as m and dx over dt. Is it right if I write this m and then d over dt and I write this x as expectation value of x? Is it right that this will also become the expectation value of momentum? So this is a question. Because this equation is classical mechanics equation, p equal to mv. If I write this in this form in x, then if I assume that this x is the expectation value of x, is it right that then this will come out to be the expectation value of momentum? So we will address this question, that can we write like this or not? So the question that we are addressing, can we write, that expectation value of p is actually m d over dt and the expectation value of x? So the very first thing, let's start from here, that what about d over dx of x? And to know this one, d over dx of this, I can write that, here I am having t sub d over dt, and x I can write that it is x psi mod square dx, because psi mod square is psi into psi conjugate. Then I can write that this is x, and when this will go, because x is not depending on time and psi is a function of position and time, so I can write 30 by 30 t and psi mod square dx. Now about 30 by 30 t psi mod square, we know that this thing is equal to this, so I will have to put this way, and then this thing is equal to, I will have to take I h bar over 2m is common, I h bar over 2m, and then integral x, and for psi mod square I can write 30 by 30 x, and psi conjugate 30 psi over 30 x minus psi 30 psi conjugate over 30 x and dx. So this one now I will have to solve, and you know that we will have to use integration by parts, and integration by parts, we know that if I am having the situation that if we are having two functions like this is, let's say, derivative of two functions d by dx, and we are having two functions f and g, then I can write this one is f and dg over dx plus df over dx, and g with it I can write the product rule. And now if I do integrate this one, integral from point A to B, and d over dx and fg, means you do integrate, you can write integration from A to B and f dg over dx plus integration from A to B, so I will have to erase this portion. Integration from A to B and df over dx and g dx. So what I have done, I have just put this value in the integral form. And now f of g, what will be this side? Means this is integrated with respect to dx. Similarly, you integrated the other side with respect to dx. Here only fg will remain, and it will be from a to b, and this thing is then equal to integration, means the same, so I can write this that means this side will remain the same as it is, is dx will cancel with dx and then d this, so we will only left with fg integration from a to b, and the other side will be as it is. So I can rearrange the terms, means rearrange these terms, and I will get integration from A to B and f dg over dx into dx is equal to, when this one will come on this side, then it will become minus integration from A to B and df over dg and g dx. And this one I will write with it, so plus f and g and the integration limits from A to B. So I have just written this thing, shuffled this thing, because I want to do some, you can say, easy calculation for my integral, which is actually this one. So I can further write them. Now I can write that d over dt and x, this is equal to I h bar over 2m from minus infinity.
Sir, why we have put it the dg in the denominator?
Dx.
This is dx. Not this one. Okay. From minus infinity to plus infinity, and x curly by curly x, and I am writing the same again, psi conjugate and curly psi over curly x minus psi and curly psi conjugate over curly x and dx. Means I wrote this thing again there in order to do integration by parts. So if I do integration by parts, I will have to utilize this formula. Look here. Why I did this? Because you see, f and the function, the second function derivative. Now here, you are giving I or h bar the function and then derivative of a function. So this is why I just converted it into this form. So I can write that this thing is equal. This thing is equal to minus I h bar over 2 minus infinity to plus infinity. And curly x over curly x and sine conjugate curly sine over curly x minus sine and curly sine conjugate with curly x. This is, you can do simple integration by parts as well if you don't like the reshuffling, but with this it becomes a bit easy. Plus I h bar and over 2m x and then sine conjugate curly sine over curly x minus curly sine over curly x conjugate and sine